Over the weekend, the New York Times reported that nearly half the early money in the 2016 presidential election has come from just 158 incredibly wealthy families. With more on how this influx of money from so few people is affecting the election, it's time for a closer look. So, half of all the money in the 2016 election so far comes from a very small number of families. Who are some of the wealthiest people in the country? Here's just one example. Chicago hedge fund billionaire Kenneth Griffin earns about $68 million a month and gave $300,000 to groups backing Republican presidential candidates. $300,000 sounds like a lot of money, but Griffin is so rich that to him, that amount is the equivalent of only $21.17 for a typical American household. So the equivalent of what we spend on a haircut or what Bernie Sanders saves by avoiding haircuts. So what effect have these kinds of donations from deep-pocketed donors had on the presidential campaign? Well, for one thing, they've made the campaigns much longer.
It used to be that when a candidate runs out of money, they have to drop out. Now it's when they run out of their sugar daddy or their sugar mama who's funding their super PAC.
And now, try to sleep tonight knowing there might be a person Chris Christie considers his sugar daddy. But what this means is that candidates with little or no support can keep running because at any point a super PAC could revive their campaign. So next time you're wondering why Bobby Jindal is still in the race, just know it's because a rich person said, "I want to see the little boy standing at the podium." "He tickles me." Another side effect of all this money flooding into campaigns is candidates have to do increasingly ridiculous things to curry favor with the wealthy donors. For example, they have to attend events like this one over the summer organized by former Republican presidential candidate Mitt Romney.
It is the most elite of retreats. 250 deep-pocketed Romney loyalists at a 5-star ski resort. 3 declared candidates, 3 likelies in a kind of shark tank competition for campaign cash.
"I hope I can find some investors. I'm a startup business."
That's right. Lindsey Graham is a startup, and his business is being a little southern fried snake. The Romney event was essentially a summer camp for millionaires, with events including sunrise yoga, horseback riding with Ann Romney, and a scenic hot air balloon ride, as well as less attended events, light stretching with John Kasich, how to change an ink cartridge with Carly Fiorina, and hunt Rand Paul for sport. But none of those could rival the most highly anticipated event of the entire summit.
A bunch of the attendees here are actually off playing flag football right now with Marco Rubio, which is kind of the highlight of this weekend.
That's right. Marco Rubio had to play flag football in an effort to get donations. And it doesn't even seem like those donors were having fun. Look at the guy on the right in this photo.
"I tell you this. I'm giving my money to a candidate who doesn't run around so much."
Still, it went better than the other time Marco Rubio played football. The problem with candidates spending this much time raising tons of money from donors is that they become indebted to them.
These candidates become focused on the support of such a tiny group of people, which is so important because these super PACs are raising far more money than they're going to raise. And the result is when they get into government, you know, who are they going to take a call from? Who are they going to listen to?
"Hey, President Rubio, it's Steve. Yeah, Steve from the football game. No, I'm fine. You were right. It was just a super bad cramp. Anyway, do you think you could get the FDA to approve asbestos as a food?" In fact, extensive research has found that the laws Congress passes are mostly in response to the needs of wealthy elites, people like the billionaire Koch brothers, who have promised to spend almost $900 million in the election and who held a summit of their own this August, a summit that allowed candidates to suck up to the 450 millionaire donors in the crowd.
"I'm honored to be here. I'm truly honored to be here. I really appreciated the invitation."
"This organization is supported by people of great accomplishment and intellect.
The men and women in this room spilled gallons of blood, spent your fortunes retaking the Senate."
That was Ted Cruz giving a compliment. "You spilled gallons of blood, and I mean that in the nicest possible way." So the candidates clearly will do or say anything for the Koch brothers' support, and on CBS this morning, Charles Koch was asked whether his efforts to influence the election have worked so far.
Has that proved more difficult than you thought?
Are you kidding? You know, it's hard to save the world when the world doesn't want to be saved.
It's hard to save the world when the world doesn't want to be saved? You sound like every Batman villain right before they get caught.
But Batman, I was just trying to save Gotham from itself.
This has been A Closer Look.